Good morning, guys. Welcome to the Shades and a brand new video today. Today we're going to talk about a good news about Willy Caballero and Olivier Giroud extending their contract, which is great news. I mean, both of them are my kind of favorite players, sort of. So I like both of them with their attitude and everything. So it's good to see that they've extended their contract. So I'm going to talk about it. I'm going to also talk a little bit about Sancho deal. So please watch the full video so you'll get the most important information, what's going on with that deal as well. So coming first about this deal with Caballero and Giroud, I must point out first is, look, if you look at the COVID situation at this moment, you know, all the world economies are almost under recession. Most of these clubs are actually losing a lot of money. There was a report earlier in the week where Manchester United is losing a lot of money. Chelsea is almost losing 100 million pounds, 100 million euros. So that just shows how much money these clubs are losing. So when these clubs are losing so much of money, it's most likely they're not going to go ahead and be able to invest in new players. And especially players will cost a lot of money, maybe 100 million or so, just like Sancho issue. So they will have to go ahead and keep the current players they have, continue extending the contract. It's like second year of transfer ban, but this is just like that. I mean, all the clubs are now facing sort of a transfer ban right now, you know, kind of. So it was quite natural to see that Giroud and Caballero's contracts were only extended, because Caballero, 40 years old, just keep him one more year as a backup to most likely Kepa. I'm coming to that. And Giroud will be a backup to Tammy Abraham, and we'll come to that also. So coming back to this whole situation, first with Caballero, almost 40 years old, played for Argentina 5 times. It's good to see. I really always wanted him to get some chances when he played, but over the last couple of years, obviously Kepa's got a lot more chances, obviously Kepa being more talented, much more younger. But right now is a situation where, will Chelsea be able to offload Kepa, which, as I was saying, most likely that's not going to happen anytime sooner, because the asking price for Kepa is huge. The kind of money he's paid by Chelsea is huge. No club will be willing to pay something like that unless getting on loan, because there were reports that maybe Frank wants to offload him. Obviously, a group of Chelsea fans don't want him and also want to be offloaded. But the situation at this moment is, with this price tag of almost 70 mil, no club is going to, at this moment with recession and everything, going to go out there and spend that kind of money on a goalkeeper. So whether he goes on a loan, there needs to be seen. But most likely he's going to stay, which means it would mean that Caballero will be number two to him. I don't see a goalkeeper coming back, or coming a new goalkeeper signing, unless Frank is adamant to get a British goalkeeper, maybe an English goalkeeper, maybe. Same goes with Giroud. Giroud is 33, World Cup winner, but he still has shown the promise in the last few matches that we played in March and February. Understand that 6 months back, in December, he was he exited Chelsea. So it's quite a surprise that he is still there and is going to be there for another 12 months. Great news. But again, what does that mean? That means that most likely Tammy will be number one. There will be no Luka Jovic, there will be no Timo Werner coming to Chelsea, as Frank has been adamant that he wants Tammy to be there at Chelsea as a number one striker. That also means that no Martins coming to Chelsea, because the Giroud coming staying, there's most likely there will be no Martins coming in. We have tend to forgot about one other striker we have. I almost forgot about Michibatsu, one of my favorite players. I know he has not performed, but what does that mean? Again, I don't think he's going anywhere. But if he goes, the asking price has to go down. I mean, his asking price is 30 mil. It might have to come down to 15 mil. Only then we'll see him going to some other club, or he'll have to be loaned out, most likely. That's the way he had to loan out, which would be a loss for Chelsea. So most likely, we will see the same time of players coming in, Tammy and Giroud, dealing with the, you know, Chelsea's strike force. That would mean a lot of goals will have to come from the midfield, you know, with the likes of ZH, Pulisic, Odoi, and, you know, players like Loftus-Cheek, Mason Mount, Loftus-Cheek, as in when he comes back, they have to bring on what Frank did when he was playing for Chelsea, getting a lot of goals from midfield. We have to get that, because I don't think personally that Tammy is a finished article, so he's not going to get you a lot of goals. You need 30 to 40 goals from a striker. I don't think Tammy is ready enough to do so. Giroud is going to come in and he will also score, but again, don't expect Giroud is going to score a lot of goals. So That's how it's going to be at the time being. Now, coming to the Sancho update I was talking about, again, as I said, with the recession and the clubs are losing so much of money, most likely most of these clubs are not going to go out there and spend. And so Sancho deal might not happen with any club this summer and might happen next season. So I don't think Dortmund is going to let him go for 80 mil at this moment, even though some club fans want that to happen. So they will obviously want something like close to 120, 130 on Sancho, unless Sancho wants to get out of Dortmund, which I don't think Sancho will want. So he'll stay back for one more year with them. And that just gives us an option, because a lot of people are saying that he's going to Manchester United. So this gives us a little bit of an option. Maybe we can give it a try next season and get him, even if it means 120 mil. Because at this moment, with the whole situation, with the COVID thing and the recession thing, it's most unlikely that any club is going to spend 120, 130 on one footballer. All the clubs are losing a lot of money. Manchester United, I heard, lost a lot of money, much more, almost 2-3 times more than what Chelsea has done. Chelsea has got 91.9 million pounds worth of losses. I think pounds or euros, or something like that, in that range. So that's a lot of money lost. So I don't see any of these clubs making a lot of high buying, you know, going for players who will cost them a lot. They will only go for maybe swap, maybe a Coutinho going to Barcelona and some Chelsea player. Rather, Coutinho coming from Barcelona and some player from Chelsea going to Barcelona. Things like these swap deals might happen, loans might happen, but big signings this summer I don't think will happen with any clubs. But next season only we'll see what happens. Jadon Sancho deal, just an update, I don't think it's going to happen with any club this summer, next season most likely. But good news at this moment is Caballero and Giroud have extended their contract, which is great. So you guys let me know, what do you guys think about the whole deal with Caballero and Giroud? Do you think there was the right choice to let them extend their contract? What do you think about the Sancho deal? Would it ever happen? Will it happen this summer? Will it happen next summer? What do you think? Chelsea will go out and buy some players? I don't think Chelsea is going to spend a lot of money on buying any players. Will spend good enough, but not will go over the top. You guys let me know in the comment section as always. Till next time, I guess. See you guys. Bye-bye.